Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_023_DIABWIE saved it. You can go and download this file or use your own file. But if you don't have access to this file, you can just sit down and watch. To create a solid between the wall and the roof to close the gap. In this tutorial, we're going to create the surface for the roof. Select the fascia board, right click and isolate object. Right click the UCS and select the face option. Hover the mouse cursor to the face of this fascia board and click. Press enter to accept. Go to the visual style control and change the visual style to 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 2D polyline command. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom in into this area and click. Move the mouse cursor up and click into this area. You can zoom in and out by rolling the mouse wheel backward and forward. Click into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select the line that you just draw and offset it into this direction. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Select the polyline command again. Start the line from this corner to this corner and press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. Type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line up. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and click the down arrow after modify. Select the mirror command. At the specified first point of mirror line prompt, use the endpoint object snap and pick. Move the mouse cursor down, turn on your auto mode if your auto is off, and click. Press enter to accept the default no option. Select this line and hit and erase it. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click into the UCS and select the face option. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button and hover the cursor into this face. Press enter to accept. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Start from this point. Continue to draw the line until you get to this point. Press escape. Select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 feet on your keyboard and type 2 inches on your keyboard and press the space bar. Select this line and offset it up. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line and erase it. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command again. Start the line from this point to this point. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 inches and press the space bar. Select this line and offset it up. Press escape. Select this line and erase it. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Now trim this line and trim this portion. Press escape. Select this line go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and click the down arrow. Select the mirror command. At the specified first point of mirror line, click this into this vertex and move your mouse cursor down. Make sure that your Odo is turned on. Click. Press enter to accept the default no option. Hold down your shift key to orbit around. Select this line and move this line into this direction. Go to the modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Select this, trim this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click the UCS and select face option. Hover the mouse cursor into this face. Press enter to accept. Select the polyline command. Start from this point, press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. Type 2 inches on your keyboard and press the space bar. Select this line and offset it up. Press escape to get out of the command. Start the 2D polyline command again. Start from this point to this point. Press escape. Press enter to start the 2D polyline command again. Start from this point to this point. Press enter to end the command. Select the offset command and type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it up. Select this line and offset it up. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line. This line. This line. Press the delete key on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this area. This area. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click the UCS and select the face option. Select the face of this object and press enter to accept. Hold down your middle shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around this area. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the 2D polyline command. Start a line from this point. Press escape. Start the polyline command again. From this point to this point. Press enter to end the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. Type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it up. Select this line, offset it out. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter, trim off this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and start the line command. Start a line from this point to this point. Press escape. Hover the mouse cursor into the right click the UCS and select the face option. Orbit into this area and select this face. Press enter to accept. Again, we have discovered another error. But if you don't have this error, yours might be fine. Just proceed. I'm going to fix this error before I move on. So if you have the same error, go to the Home tab and select the line command. Start the line from this vertex and move it to the vertical direction. Press escape. Press enter to start the line command. start the line from this vertex and move it to the vertical direction. Press escape. Now use the press pull command. Click on this area and move the mouse cursor out and type 1 inch. Press enter. Do the same thing into this area and snap the press pull into this corner. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select this object and this solid, press enter. Press enter to repeat the union command again. Select this object and the solid, press enter. Now select this line, and erase the line. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, zoom in into this area and start the polyline into this vertex. Move on to this corner. This corner. Press escape to get out of the command. Start the polyline command again. Start the line from this corner to this corner. Press escape. Press the space bar. Start from this corner to this corner. Press escape. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 inches and press the space bar. Offset this line up and offset this line out. Offset this line up. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line, and this line. Hit delete on the keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this area, this area, this area, this area. Press enter to get out of the command. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this drawing to 00_024_DIAB and click the save button. This will save the drawing into new name. That way you cannot affect the previous work that you have done. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the rectangle command. At the specified start point prompt, select this corner and move the mouse cursor until it snaps into this. Hover the mouse cursor until it snaps into this corner. Press enter to start the rectangle command again. Start from this corner and move the mouse cursor until you snap into this corner. Hold down your shift key to orbit around. Select the rectangle command again. As specified first corner point prompt, select this corner. Now move to the in this area and select this corner. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select the rectangle command again. At the specified first corner prompt, select this corner and this corner. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. Start the rectangle command again. Start from this corner and hover the mouse cursor into this area. AutoCAD snap at the right level. Press enter to start the rectangle command. Start from this corner to this corner. Start the rectangle command again. Start from this corner to this corner. Select these rectangles. Now hold down your control key and type 1 on your keyboard. This will bring the properties palette. Change the color so that the color can stand out from the rest of the other cabbage layer objects. Let's use the blue color options. Close the properties palette. Now go to the home tab and click the down arrow after modify panel and click the extrude to extrude this rectangle. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Select this line and offset it out. Select this line, offset it out. Select this line, offset it out. This line, offset out. This line, offset out. This line, offset out. This line, offset out. And this line, offset out. 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 Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type R and press enter. Type 0, press enter. Type M, press enter. Select this line, fillet it to this line, fillet this line 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 to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it into this direction. Press escape. Select this line and erase it. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. AutoCAD still remember the previous radius. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press enter to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the 2D polyline command. Start a line from this vertex and move it to this direction. Click. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, this polyline. Hover your mouse cursor into this vertex and select remove. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the polyline command. Select this line and join it with this line. Select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line, and this line to this line, this line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape. Select this line and erase it. Select the fillet command again. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line, this line to this line. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line, this line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, and select the erase button. Hold down your shift key and orbit to see the result. Now, orbit into this area. Select the fillet command. type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and this line, this line and this line, this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Start the affiliates command again. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and this line, this line and this line, this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Select this line and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line, this line, this line, this line and press enter. Auto guard join this line into one holy line. Press enter again to repeat the join command. Select these lines, this line, this, this line, this line, press enter. Auto guard join this object again into one polyline. Press enter to repeat the join command. Select this line, 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 select this line and press enter. Auto guard join this line into one polyline. Orbit around. Let's select this line to see if this line is already a closed polyline. Press enter to repeat the join command again. Select this line, 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 press enter. Auto guard join all the line into one object. Now select this line, this polyline, this polyline, this polyline. This polyline and go to the surface tab, grid panel, select plan. AutoCAD converts them into a surface plan. Select this polyline and select the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Select this polyline and select the extrude command. Move inside and type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Select this polyline and the extrude command. Type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Orbit, select this polyline. Go to the grid panel, surface tab, grid panel, and select the extrude command. Move into this direction and type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Select this polyline, select the extrude command. Move into this area and type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Go to the visual style control and select change to realistic. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the layer properties manager. Select the facial bold layer and click the create new button. This way the new layer take on the properties of the facial bold. Rename this layer to surface and press enter on your keyboard. Close the layer properties manager. Select this surface, right click, select similar, and move the surface by going to the layer panel and select the surface layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this, right click, select similar, go to the layer and move it to the surface layer. Press escape. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. Our surface is being created nicely. Alright, in this tutorial you create surface for your building. We will continue to create surface for the bottom roof in the next tutorial. If you found this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your colleague. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please click the subscribe button. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.